So we get to clear cuts between the creative talk and the testing.
Be right back.
Okay. It's not letting me join.
Oh, I needed to tweak the mods.
Oh, okay.
Back out. World's up.
I lost audio.
Downloading 4 of 10 mods, joy. Wondering what the final models for the Gatling guns and the missile turrets will be, because I don't think the models we're using now are the final ones. I think they're still placeholders.
Yeah, yeah, that's what Rotel was saying earlier, that she wants them changed now. But yeah,
I mean, make it fit a 3x3 hitbox a little better, because right now it's kind of ridiculous.
Yeah. Just make something that looks that it can actually reload.
Yeah, that's my big thing.
Yeah, the missile launcher has like the weirdest shape.
Okay, here's my more heavily armored ship.
Mm-hmm.
This is my budget frigate.
And you probably get a little more firepower out of it though. Probably with not much modification either. Put a couple more of those 230mm cannons on her. See, I noticed you put your big guns on the side. I'd put mine on the dorsal and ventral sections, just for the simple fact that way, if you're doing a pass, all your heavy ordnance is coming at somebody. Of course, you can always roll the ship, so.
And this thing's always intended to fight head on, so. Even if you were doing a pass, you would want to steer into them.
Yeah. Or you could just roll your ship 90 degrees and just take them that way, but.
Mm-hmm. It's actually most vulnerable from the top and bottom.
So. Ventral and dorsals are your weak points, yeah. Or what you do to solve that problem is you do is center down the center line heavy armor with decoys underneath it. That way, it all the impact.
It does have a heavy armor spine.
That does sound sweet. Yeah. That's one thing I saw JD do. He put heavy armor spines in his ships, and I will say that does work quite well.
JD does heavy armor on everything.
It doesn't do a totally heavy armor. If you look at some of his designs, he's actually started doing composites. But he does use heavy armor a lot, though. Well, I use heavy armor too much, and it ticks me off because I don't like using heavy armor.
Yeah, I was like that before, and then I just changed to composites.
Yeah, I try to only like reinforce places that keep getting hit.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Yeah, what I do now is I just do like a few battle testings, and whatever gets, you know, deformed, I turn into heavy armor. Yep. I mean, consistently.
There's a decoy and welder set up in the hammerhead here.
Yeah, I figure as much. It's a good place for it. That'll absorb all the fire and take it off your turrets. And now with decoys working again. How thick's the armor right there?
Just one block thick.
Eh. Wanna go 1.5 to 2, but how can we do it here? Mind if I make a few changes?
Yeah, if you want.
My toolbars again. I wish they'd make it where toolbars would just go by the player.
Yeah.
That way you can carry it over regardless of whatever server you were on.
That on the character too. Like whatever colors, whatever colors you have.
Ships and the servers, that was one of my pet peeves. Cheap way of adding a little extra armor to the front of your ship without spending a lot. Expect it'll look, but.
See, the thing I couldn't figure on was what to fill this center space with that would look good.
Yeah, that's always the problem. What do we got we can fill it with?
The air vent is the only one that has that same height.
Yeah.
Unless you add the slam.
Desperately need a half block.
Mm-hmm. Several half blocks. For example, like one that would join these two half slants.
Yeah. Or they need to deform a block that can deform into those spaces, guaranteed with it on the side of it, not with everything else that's around it.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I have used the deform blocks to my advantage here and there, but they're very, you know, few and far between.
Yeah.
I just put a grate there. There you go.
Mm-hmm.
Well, if you take a step inside, you can get a quick tour of the interior.
Oh, wow.
You have an airlock script in here, don't you?
Yep. Whiplash's airlock script, so. That's the ladder to the topside airlock, which gets you to the landing pad. These over here are just crew quarters.
Quarters on the side, and back here is probably where all the magic happens. Engineering. Hydrogen thrusters. A lot of interesting sloped armor back here.
Yeah, it's by putting the non-attaching faces of the 2-1 slopes next to the jump drive, right. You can't get deformation damage transferring right. From the armor into the jump drive.
Oh, that's useful as hell. That is very useful. On a lot of ships, I just use the filler pieces and attach it to the armor and leave a gap around it, but I gotta try that one. That looks pretty good. Yeah, just learn something new I can utilize in future designs. Course, if you're trying to use your jump drive to make things airtight, not gonna work so good. There's your cockpit right there for battle.
That's the coward cockpit.
That adds for when your main bridges got blown to hell and you need to fall back to your secondary.
This is med bay in here.
Instead of med bay, I try to keep all my med bays close to the command center.
No, this is still fairly close, but
Yeah.
It's a little further back to help make sure it's protected.
I
It's an
understand we're
alarms locker.
That's right, you're going for role play here, so that's fine. Ooh, wow, you're right up front. This is actually a very well-sheltered bridge. It's protected, plus it's back enough where it's not going to take direct fire.
Yeah, I mean,
Except.
in our in this is actually a pretty old design, so we've tested it a lot. It's just recently that it got some rework on the gun mounts and engineering and all the thrusters and all that. But the general hammerhead and kind of bridge placement has remained the same, and you can fly it from here without too much worry. You know, the being in the shadow of the chin of the hammerhead and the double glass here usually keeps it pretty well protected,
Yeah, double glass
especially
right there.
if you tilt nose down a little bit and try to use your top guns as much as you can,
Yeah, especially
then
if you're taking lots of fire.
yeah.
But usually I do my bridge in like a total armored box, but this works. You got the vital areas underneath and the sides protected. I'm guessing the turrets are right around this area too, just below the bridge.
Yeah.
Good spot for them, so. That way the turrets will take all the fire and draw it away from the bridge too. But. There's the opening for the bridge right there. Oh, that's really well protected. You're not going to draw much fire there at all because it's going to any weapons fire is going to want to go for the guns first. That's actually a very safe spot for a bridge. Unless someone's using direct fire weapons, in that case, you're in a world of crap. But
Well, even then, again, you just keep the hammerhead down a little bit and let the top 122s and the 230s do the work.
way I take out a ship like this is overwhelmed with rocket fire. Not the best tactic, but it works. Like the ion hydrogen combination.
Yeah, that was my that was me saying, okay, let's try to do this budget. So it's very, very sparse on the ions and relies a lot on the hydrogens. It's got about
What's the resource level on your server in terms of production and stuff?
we do 3x inventory, 1x everything else.
Yeah.
Okay. So you're not going to overwhelm anything then. I like 3x inventory and stuff like that because I mean, the 1x production, it's what's your refinery limit?
We don't get a lot of people yet, so we haven't really
Another one.
implemented SESE,
Yeah,
so.
exactly. And to be fair, it's not like we can actually like host a lot of people.
I mean, we've been intending to implement SESE, but with how regularly we seem to lose our server or Keen fuck something up that takes the server down
Yeah.
anyway, it's like
Well, like
So
more.
here's the production thing we built up. It uses the TIM inventory script. This is just the production half. But
Oh.
designed where you can add more refineries on. There's one refinery for every material. If you need more, add them on. But then it uses the programming for TIM. Each assembler is set up to do a different component. It's as small and compact as I can get it.
You don't have any problems running this thing? Full tilt?
Fully loaded.
Well,
I mean, the problem I have with TIM is the TIM script is, or Talent Inventory Management System, is the refinery setup is I'll need certain materials and it'll be busy refining other things first.
Mm.
So I bypass that part and just use it for the assemblers.
I
usually
see.
The refineries in vanilla.
That's a good idea. I mean,
that way you're not using all that stuff for all the scripting, you're just using it for the assemblers.
I mean, you guys host your own server, right?
Oh, we used to.
Do you rent it?
CIA Gaming is who we got it off of. They were running it on their own box, so. Then almost some of the servers you rent are virtual servers. You know, you got a couple servers running on a machine. If you own the box for the server.
Hmm.
We're talking to CIA Gaming if you're looking for a server. I mean, it's done it in the past. I do like vanilla and modded weapons. I do like modded weapons, though. They look cooler. I mean, that's the one thing Space Engine needs, is a big friggin' cannon.
Yeah. I mean, they definitely need more weapons variety. I don't know if they ever gonna add guided missiles, like...
That'd be nice, or add torpedoes or something. I mean, you don't have to be missiles. Or whatever,
mm-hmm.
Yeah, it drifts a little bit, but that's about right for what you need.
Yeah.
In combat, you don't really want to sit still. Got good braking, though, I'll say that.
It is a well-balanced frigate.
And what do you guys use for a building ship, for, like, building bigger ships?
Nanites.
But do you use small ships or you use large ships, Father?
Actually, small ships.
Oh no!
Oh.
There you go. Now, in the Second Sun Alliance, we developed a method of drag welding that works actually fairly well, where you can build a large ship in a hell of a hurry. And we use this fun little ship to do it with. Is that up right? Yeah, that's right. Set up.
I once made a. Oh.
This is the Cadillac, because it is expensive as hell. Got one large container in there, six welders. You'd actually start on a projection in the center line, then drag backwards. Do a full row. Then you'd come back up to the side, get right up against it, drag backwards. If there's any large containers or like 3x3 objects that get in your way, you grind those out first, dump the container contents back in the container, and then keep going.
I see.
And you can get an entire ship built really fast. We could build ships like your little frigate there. We probably could crank out probably one of those in about 45 minutes or less.
Nice.
Hell, probably could even do a couple and a half hour. Okay, you're using the compact weld tools. I love that. Welder and grinder unit? And nice. Very nice.
Yeah, that's my basic construction ship.
Where's the one I got from the Second Sun Alliance? I know I had one somewhere. Probably in my archives folder. I got so many blueprints, I had to create an archives folder just to store shit in. Sad, I know. I collect crap.
Yeah, blueprint hoarding is kind of like, a thing.
See, they need to set up a folder system, that way you can, like, organize it.
Mm-hmm.
Well, throw down, a fighter or something. They grab a fighter.
Here's one. If you guys are using those modded welders, here's a good ship for you. For a small one. Where are the welders?
I see two large cargo, right? No.
Yeah, got two or more.
Two medium. Four medium.
And you got one of each welder there, so you got, you know, small, medium, large, so.
Nice.
Gives you your options. And then if you open vanilla, you got the basic design. Just pop the welders or grinders on, and you change it out as you need it.
See, the thing that I specifically wanted to address with the Terrapin was that when you get a welder ship like this, you know, fully loaded, the maneuverability gets really bad, and you start risking crashing into things and
that's why
losing
the
ship,
like,
losing a container of it. So I went really heavy on the thrusters on the Terrapin.
Yeah, this little utility ship doesn't get too heavy. It's actually pretty manageable when it gets heavy. As long as you're not going like above 20 meters a second, you're pretty much good. Nice little ship we retrofitted. Better than my old PvP designs, I'll say that much. Okay, you want to get a fighter out here and do some battling?
Yeah, you can try and deal with some of the drones we've got.
Type 5 handles up combat here.
I'm gonna bring one of mine, and after that, I will log off.
Is that your fighter right there?
Yep, this is mine.
Oh my god, I'd get massacred against that thing. Look at the guns in that damn thing, holy shit. Those are 40 millimeter?
23.
Yeah, 23 millimeter versus my Gatling gun. I'd get. Whoa.
I think I got
the higher rate of fire, but you got the better stopping power.
Actually, this is using my OKI rebalance, so these are actually less DPM than the Gatlings, and
okay.
Slower rate of fire. They hit slightly harder than the Gatlings, but they have better accuracy. So overall, you have the DPM advantage with the Gatlings, and also rolled into the OKI rebalance as our vanilla weapons rebalance, so the velocity advantage is only 100 meters a second for the 23s instead of the Gatlings being stuck at 300 meters a second. They're 600. Where'd you go? High ground.
I'm over here. I got a surprise for you. Incoming.
Oh no!
My first attempt to easy whips missile script. Turn, damn it, turn. Hit him, minute. Oh. Inaccurate as shit.
I lost it. Oh, I see it.
Yeah, these things are designed for like taking out something a lot bigger than what you are. Come on. I missed, didn't I?
Oh, nope, you got me that time, I think.
I think I desynced. Did you fire another missile?
He fired like three or four of them.
Oh, okay. But yeah, I'm not syncing really well.
Yeah, take back the pistons off. Is that we're
going? Oh!
Why are we shooting?
I'm shooting at the missile.
No, he's shooting at me. I don't know why he's shooting at me.
I'm shooting at you. What the hell? I'm shooting at the missile. I mean, on my screen, I'm shooting at the missile.
High ground is shooting.
Oh,
at me.
Okay.
I'm sorry about that. Oh, I think they even got a jump drive in it? Damn.
Yeah.
I think I'd have fun at your server using the mini jump drive.
It's supposed to be balanced compared to the large ones. It's it actually takes a lot of power to charge it. And its jump range is very short.
How far are we talking in terms of jumping?
100 kilometers, and it'll only move 125 kilogram.
Okay.
and it takes about 15 minutes to fully charge.
Very situational. What about for short jumps? Is it viable for that, or?
Yeah, I mean, it's mostly meant to kind of make carrier-based fighters something you would actually see, so that you don't have to expose the carrier in order to do a strike, or sit in your cockpit for forever and do a strike. And it also gives fighters kind of a little bit of a even footing with like a Corvette, where the Corvette, a large grid ship, would have a jump drive and be able to always chase down the fighter because they're limited to the same kind of movement parameters. It gives the fighter an out for if it, you know, runs up against something bigger.
Protect is coming. If you run into something bigger, you run and lead it into an ambush.
Anyway, join the faction High Ground. Yeah, this is my multi-role strike fighter, so it has these merge blocks that you can carry the weapon pods on if you need to do dogfighting, but it can also carry guided missiles or, you know, rocket pods or whatever else.
It's a lot more versatile then. Got a jump seat in it or no?
Nope.
Yeah, something to add in the next model. Yeah, my little fighter looks ridiculous next year. Which I guarantee mine be harder to hit. Well, since you got bigger weapons, I'm going to add bigger weapons to mine.
Since Marcelo probably needs to go to bed soon, we should.
Yeah. I've seen that fighter before, the Marcello's flying.
Oh, yeah, I think it was tested by the Second Sun Alliance. Submitted.
Great design. One thing it couldn't take really well was a cockpit hit.
Yeah.
Show me a fighter that can't.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, my fighters are definitely a little more on the RP side than effective side. It's hard to call it effective when it has this forward cockpit.
Well, when you once put decoys back, I just put decoys in the wings, you're set.
True. Very true.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I was actually talking to Tank Maven, and I was like, I need to make some decoy missiles for this thing to go on the hard points. So I can just fire decoys in and then follow them in.
Yeah, you can do up to 5 decoys on a merge block, and then just stack it like that, and then if they get shot and hit, they'll break apart and fly off.
He was telling me that you actually want to have something where it's got a Gatling gun aimed at a merge block, and the merge block...
Yeah, it used to work pretty well, and then they changed something where you can't shoot your own grid or something.
Hmm.
What?
Oh. Yeah, the last time we tried it out, it didn't work too well. All right, so who are we going after first? That business shipment?
You see the military escort spawner?
Yep.
Yeah, if we get close enough to that, it'll start spawning escorts for us to fight.
Don't attack it. There's a spawner in the asteroid. Hey, let's go out and just ruin someone's day.
Oh, I don't see your ship. I just see you flying. But your character. These bugs.
Yeah, I'm probably getting small. I got the smallest ship here. Harder to hit.
That actually helps a lot. Ooh, there they are.
Military escort, tally ho. Yeah, this thing, this little fighter I got's only good for 20 minutes, though. Then the battery's dead.
It's okay, we're in creative.
Mm-hmm. I know. This is designed to be a short run fighter.
Well, what the hell?
Oh, I'm desyncing. Like, the thing is just like moving around like crazy.
I apparently got cockpit sniped and it like snapped me to like spectator view of the center. Like, I don't know.
Could be because you're the host, I guess.
I don't know.
Trying to peel off the turrets of this thing, but I cannot see anything. Oh. Nah.
Oh, right. This little fighter's doing a work here.
Yeah, I think you're going to have better luck. I'm desyncing really badly, and
I lost.
I think I lost all my guns, yeah.
Yep, just took a hit.
But at least I survived. I'm just gonna stay in to act as a decoy.
You guys partying without me?
Yes.
Oh.
I mean, you just arrived and.
Yeah, one of my launchers is out. And I'm missing a forward thruster, but I'm still alive.
I think I'm gonna do the honorable thing.
Very honorable. You hitting the business shipment?
Nope.
Ah, oh, come on.
Oh, the escorts. Alright, I'm four clicks out, heading towards. Yeah, I'll take the patrol craft.
Oh, whoa. What the hell?
Almost took that thing on. Almost ate that thing.
Oh, this thing.
Oh, damn. What the hell are those guns?
Friendly fire.
Alright, go
take
the
that.
Craft. Oh, never mind. He's dead.
Yeah, that one's toast.
Oh, fuck.
Ooh, I'm on fire.
I'm on.
Yeah.
Fire. Ah, come on. Fucking hell.
Desync?
Yeah, the fucking I aim at the thing was about to take out its antenna and the game twitched and I was suddenly aiming 90 degrees off to the
left. Yeah.
What little ship is that you're using? It's like a mini Halo ship.
Oh, where'd it... Oh, wow. Thing just explode?
No, I deleted it because it was... It had gone ballistic. It was dead.
Oh, we got more escorts incoming.
Time for me to use the PvP 3 sniper.
Whoa.
Well, so much for the sniper. Gotta back off a little bit and then respawn in.
Ugh, I can't react to any of this fire because I fucking skip every time I go near the ship.
Mm-hmm.
I can't even tell if the thing's shooting because every time it fires its guns, my game freezes.
You know, I think shooting missiles at thing exacerbates. Oh, God. Yeah. I mean, whatever it is, like, I just come close. As soon as I get close to a ship.
As soon as we're in weapon range, it
yeah.
Freaks out.
I'm really surprised that. Okay, finally.
Alright, patrol craft, you little shit. Come here.
I should turn my welder on, that helps.
A little bit.
Little thing wrecked my ass.
Oh.
See how my gunboat does.
Damn it. I base this thing too early. Oh! Yes. Lost
yeah,
all gyros.
Run away, little bitch. Well, glad to know that my decoy bits are doing their job. Who's got the alarm going off?
Beacon.
Alright, he's pretty much gone.
Bring in some heavy fire support here.
Copy. Oh, something caught on fire.
Alright, I think we got that one. He's bugging out.
Hey, it's Terry, if you guys can hear you there. I'm gonna take off.
Okay, it's laser. Have a good one.
Well, I'm surprised how well the guns worked on this.
Night.
Guy's about to regret ever being born.
I already regret that.
Oh, he's going away from me. I can't close on him.
Yeah, he's out of guns, so he's bugging out.
Oh. On some
Let's
more.
Let's destroy his antenna and his dignity.
No, a drone could have dignity. When's that damn thing gonna spawn more?
Soon.
Soon.
Looking forward to seeing how this gunship holds up.
Oh wow! Suddenly the game's all smooth and
mm-hmm.
nice.
Okay, that monitor looks like a hell of a little fighter. Is that a drone?
Nope. See, it's got a bridge on top.
It's a micro
yeah,
frigate.
Oh, that's awesome. That's a small block ship, though, isn't it?
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, it looks about the same size as my gunboat when I'm like looking up close. It's like, hey, there's another ship in the distance.
No, I'm 40 meters away.
I know. I mean, that's. There's how you can do things with optics. Put small ships next to big ships, and they look, you know, at up close, they look like, you know, you got a whole fleet of ships. I mean, that's the thing you'd use. You build a bunch of ships that look like they're, you know, like
that's
the bigger version, and then launch them at the enemy, and they think they're decoys, and they'll start attacking them.
A bit like, oh, fill them with decoys. That'd be even better.
Nope, mm-hmm. going, coming in.
Now let's go say hello.
Looks like it's saying hello to Dorn.
Yeah, I was outside of my ship.
And it gets eviscerated.
Damn, look at that.
Ah, my camera.
I stripped out its ability to reload the forward launchers. I stripped all the ammo right out of them.
Yeah, I mean, having a large grid as support makes the world a world of difference. Oh, I'm getting into your firing solution. God damn it.
No.
Cannot move.
Whoa, taking fire from another target on the opposite side.
So laggy.
I'm on the patrol craft.
And I'm about to have an accident. Shit! Break, damn it, break! I'm not going that fast. Ooh!
I'm taking hits from somewhere. Oh, there it is.
My damn, it looks worse than it actually is.
this, I can actually predict where the rounds are going. Ah. Nice.
Are you using a whip script?
No, it's just that the mod with the what's it called?
Oh, you have it installed, Seth?
What?
It's just the modded weapons. The modded weapon stats. Really nice.
Oh man, I can barely control this thing.
How the hell did that get hit?
Yeah, that's the the antenna that the military transporter will use. So that's on top of that fight. You also have to try to capture the transporter before it leaves.
It's gotta be like a sizable team effort.
Yeah.
Wow. The rubber banding is real.
I'm surprised this thing is actually still somewhat capable.
Here we go. Here's one I modified for another faction. They wanted a fighter, and they gave me one of the UESC's fighters, and I modified it.
Whoa. Who's someone shooting rockets?
That was me.
Alright.
You want a closer look at the Gorgon?
Here, I'll fly over to you.
Let me put in a fresh one.
Oh wow. Where do you get in? Oh, right in the cockpit? Oh, this thing is awesome.
And it's got a second seat behind that.
Oh wow. So
back here.
Did you get to the second seat?
I'm gonna check the fighter and then I'll have to log off.
Well, these would be the ultimate little fighters right here.
Ooh. Wow, this is really cool. Yeah, I like the Gatling arrangement.
Talk about your forward firepower plus the turrets, man. Damn, this thing's a beast. We'll be the poor bastard who shoots at this thing.
I need to finish the vanilla version.
Well, the vanilla version probably doesn't look as cool.
It's reasonable.
A little bigger?
No, same size.
I can see the missile turrets working good in the sides, but the Gatlings on top are going to look a little odd, but...
The turrets actually help protect the cockpit, because it's a big hitbox.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And you can also use the turret to help you lead.
True.
Which you can see it from the...
Crap.
The entire, like... Well, let me open up the side of it. Assuming the plane cut will work.
Wow. Okay, so you got a welder up front for self-repair to keep the guns operational. You got the whole fuselage, nothing but hydrogen tanks. You have up-down connectors?
Gun mounts for the large to a small connector or conveyor thing.
Oh. Well, you just wanted the conveyor port. Oh, you want to go from large to small. All right. I get you. Makes sense now.
What about the, what are the, where's the hydrogen thrusters that you're using for?
Nose section, I think it's got them returning.
Yeah, it's got two small for retro, but they're kind of irrelevant unless you're, because they'll go down in a fight pretty easy, but it has two left, right, up, down on the front section. The expensive
more thrusters than if you wanted to.
The expensive ion thrusters are all at the back, so they get damaged less often.
Well, those are a different. Oh, a 2x2 ion thruster. Who the hell designed that? You give them a medal.
Yeah.
That's a block that needs to happen.
Definitely.
Yeah,
that's
I use Axline's thruster pack, and it has 2x2s and 3x3s.
I love how they make things all these odd shapes, and they force you. You got to figure out how to combine all this crap together like Jenga or something. Put a square peg into the round hole. Got the antenna so you can remote control it if you want to.
It's dual antennas in case you lose one.
Yeah, not sure how effective the antenna would be, but... I mean, because, you know, in a combat situation, you get out of line of sight or get shot, but...
Oh, yeah, the laser antenna... I include it just kind of greebling reasons and lore and, like, you know, kind of like the idea of it, but when we've tested them, we found that laser antennas are absolutely worthless, and they're actually counterproductive, because if you have a damaged laser antenna and you try to repair it or grind it down, it can crash the server.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Huh. Is that with just the modded ones or the vanilla?
Vanilla. Any laser antenna.
Yeah.
They should make it a lot more useful. Like, maybe have a sensor. Sweet, entire sensor.
Well, the laser antenna, the thing that pisses me off is the range.
Yeah, the range makes them, like...
I actually heard that it's the largest range on the antenna that applies, so if you have a large to a small, the small grid's small range doesn't matter.
Hmm.
So even the large ones only got a range of, like, what, like 50,000 or something? Or?
I think it's 60K.
60K? I mean, okay, it's 10 better than a regular one. I mean, you can't see it, but...
Yeah.
I was hoping laser induction, like, over 100,000 or something. Or
yeah.
I mean, they would be interesting to use if they worked.
I always thought that it was... when I first saw it come out, I thought it was, like, some sort of sensor. Like, it had... You could go in it, it had a telescoping camera that was a lot... had better zoom capability.
Oh, that would be awesome. I mean, they
some infrared, some radar on it, just have it be a whole, yeah. Not radar, but, you know.
No, I mean, why not? I mean, have, like, the whole package, like, you know, optical, thermal, FLIR, whatever.
Yeah,
and
they saw. Sorry.
And, no, I was just going to say that a fire control block would be amazing.
Yeah. Because I saw the ports on it, and I thought those were just different types of sensors. So it was like a combination of all the sensors in one, and you could aim it anywhere you wanted.
Mm-hmm.
Only,
yeah.
At the expense of one, and maybe extra components. That's what I thought.
Yeah, two jump drives in it
was. Then I read it, and I'm like, oh, it's just an antenna.
Yeah.
That'd be neat if someone modded that in.
True. I mean... The laser antenna by itself is not a bad idea. It's also that the fire control block, it needs to happen too.
Well, the fire control I'd love to see happen just for the simple fact that if they ever added turrets into the game, that way you could control, you know, okay, here's your fire control block, assign your turrets to the fire control block.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, this fire control block controls your forward, this one controls your rear. So in, like, in player-based combat, you could actually make things interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Like with, I always thought it'd be nice, like with Eve, where you can get a group of turrets and assign them all. You could lock a ship and assign these turrets to one ship and these turrets to the other ship and split up your coordinates.
I mean, you
as,
kind of...
As
kind
clunky as the, you know, the EVE overview is, Space Engineers needs it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Better a clunky overview than none.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. No, I was just going to say, like, that mod, the one that advanced turret control... that one kind of like does that. I mean, you group the turrets and you can use them like that, and it's simplified in the way that any turret in the group that you control, then the other ones follow. Having a dedicated fire control block, it would, you know, actually allow for some gameplay and some actual design elements for you to explore. Like, okay, I want to put the fire control blocks here. They are going to be, you know, exposed, but at the same time, I'm going to have that capability. So it's just add something interesting to the designs instead of, you know, just making dead cubes. I gotta go. It's been amazing to play with you guys again after all this busy week that I've been having. So, no, definitely I'm gonna do more of these streams. Definitely more testing.
And should have gotten here sooner.
Yeah, no, we've been having fun, actually. And we were just like talking like for hours, and it was really entertaining. But I really cannot wait until they fix multiplayer, so all this stupid broadbanding.
This year, otherwise, I don't think a lot of people are going to stick around.
yeah, definitely.
It's like been going on year three. It's like, come on, guys, get your shit together.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I like what you're doing, but I'm not going to wait forever for you to do it.
True. I mean, dedicated servers are kind of like meh right now because of that. There's no way.
They kind of rolled it out there before it was ready, which was part of the problem.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow. Symmetry's not working.
Or we don't have it turned on.
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Well.
Not sure, Dan.
In any case, you guys have fun, and I'll catch you on Sunday.
Alright. Catch you later.
Okay.
See ya.